Guys, the stove runs on water. Is it even real? Yes. You know that I like to do everything different from everyone else. Today will also be as usual. Everything is not usual. Super cool idea. Hello, friends. I wanted to make everything from a rusty pipe, but it is very rusty. I found a scrap in the bins. I would certainly like to make it out of a large one, but I'm tormented to clean it off. See what a magician I am up. And the pipe is split. It will take 3 rounds. Lid, bottom, and semi-bottom semi-lid. The pipe diameter is 132 millimeters, approximately plus or minus. Here such a pipe will be in the middle in 2 covers. Here you can take a larger diameter, but there should be a space between the walls. I took an approximate one that came to hand, a diameter of 42 millimeters. Plus or minus. There will be another hole nearby, but only in 1 cover. The hole for the pipe is 1/2 inch, approximately 22 millimeters. Of course, cutting with plasma without a compass, or without a template, is not neat enough, but there will be welding seams, so you cannot pay any attention to this. Plasma really expands the possibilities, but it does not replace the angle grinder, but simply complements and speeds up the work. The same can be done with crowns and angle grinders. Here's what happened. Lid with a hole in the middle, lid with 2 holes and a blind lid as the bottom. This pipe, 1/2 inch, is just right for this little hole. For this part of the design in the store took 2 turns at 90 degrees. I'll cut them and weld them together to make a full turn of steam. The flow will come from the small pipe. Unfortunately, this pipe I had was the smallest of the steel ones. I would certainly take thinner. There is an M6 thread and it fits perfectly with the M6 coupling, which I will then weld onto the end of the pipe. Everything is becoming clearer now. I grabbed the central pipe, later I will scald it hermetically. I cleaned the flow pipe and found another nozzle, it is a little shorter. I don't know the correct nozzle hole diameter yet. The lower part, where there will be oil, will be from a smaller piece of pipe. And of course the bottom will be welded to this part. And the most important feature of the design, the small pipe will be located like this. The nozzle will be directed parallel to the inner tube, forming an air jet pump. Due to the pressure in the steam generator. Guys, let me take you away from the project for a minute. Integrations help me make interesting videos for you. I think that it is possible to use not only used or vegetable oil as fuel, but also diesel fuel. And if you try to make blowing in an ash pan from below, then you can try it on pellets. And of course, make them automatically fed into the furnace. The location of the nozzle should approximately be at the cut of the outlet pipe. I did a little further away so that it was possible to replace the nozzle with a different diameter or if it failed. This design is used in various mechanisms in industries and enterprises. Now I'm going to finish everything. 2 more couplings will be welded on the body to control pressure and temperature. Well, for curiosity and in case of emergency. As I said earlier, the design is experimental and even the dimensions are taken without calculations. Much can be improved, but the most important thing here is the principle of work itself. From a piece of pipe with a thread and a 90-degree drive, I want to make necks for water into the compartment of the steam gas generator and for oil into another compartment. As a matter of fact, everything is ready. I paint, as always, from a spray can, with heat-resistant paint up to 1000 degrees Celsius from Vixen. I used a lot of various other paints, settled on these. Beautiful, high quality and simply cool. Everything dried up quickly, I collect. I have bought safety valves for a long time. Recognize which one did not work out. Signed from approximately based on the strength of the spring inside. The valve will protect the water part from too high pressure. I put about 5 kilograms. Since this is still an experiment, I decided to put a thermometer and a pressure gauge. The thermometer has a limit of 120 degrees Celsius. A pressure gauge with a limit of 12 atmospheres, but just in case, a safety valve for 5 atmospheres. The main thing is that I'm not mistaken with him. Now the long-awaited test. I silt the oil into the lower compartment, I did not weld it, so that I could experiment with different nozzle diameters. and a glass of water in the upper compartment. Neck caps are regular 1/2-inch plumbing plugs. Water cap with elastic band for sealing. I set it on fire with gasoline to make it faster. Now the water will boil and the steam will go to the air gas pump and increase the draft in the pipe several times. A stove, well, or a burner, very interesting, works without electricity and moving parts, on oil and water. If you want, cook food, but if you want, you can use it for heating, as a burner for a boiler or boiler.
Wow!
Unexpected power and just incredible traction. Yes, this is some kind of nuclear reactor. You have to be careful with this thing. We need to figure out how to regulate the power and how to turn it off. Guys, if you liked it, like, subscribe, bell. All useful links on the video in the description and in the pinned top comment. Health and kindness to you and your loved ones. Thanks for watching this video. See you on the channel, friends.